बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे इन दिस सेकंड लेक्चर फॉर वीक 10 वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ हायर ऑर्डर लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस फॉर द कोर्स अप्लाइड मैथमेटिक्स 2। दिस वीडियो लेक्चर इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ माय प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर। In the previous video lecture, we have learned about the nature of the roots of characteristic equations. We have already discussed case number 1, that when the roots of the characteristic equation are real and different, then the complementary solution will be equal to c1 e power m1x plus c2 e power m2x plus c3 e power m3x and so on for nth root cn e power mnx. Now today we are going to discuss second case when roots are real and repeated. Suppose m1 is equal to m2 and m2 is equal to k, and m3, m4 up to mn are different, then the complementary solution, the complementary function will be equal to c1 plus c2x into e power kx plus c3 e power m3x plus and so on plus cn e power mnx. And if suppose m1 is equal to m2, m2 is equal to m3 is equal to k, and m4, m5 and so on up to mn are different roots, then the complementary function will be equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square into e power kx plus c4 e power m4x plus and so on plus cn e power mnx. Suppose we have example y triple dash minus 6y double dash plus 12y dash minus 8y is equal to 0. This differential equation can be written as d cube minus 6d square plus 12d minus 8 into y is equal to 0. Now the auxiliary equation for this differential equation is m cube minus 6m square plus 12m minus 8 is equal to 0. Now we are going to find the roots for this auxiliary equation. By factor theorem, suppose we want to consider m is equal to 2. If this m is equal to 2, if we put m is equal to 2 in this auxiliary equation, 8 minus 24 plus 24 minus 8 is equal to 0. If we put m is equal to 2, we obtain from this auxiliary equation 2 power 3 minus 6 into 2 power 2 plus 12 into 2 minus 8 is equal to 0. And after simplifications, we obtain 8 minus 24 plus 24 minus 8 is equal to 0, which implies that 0 is equal to 0. So m is equal to 2 is the root of this auxiliary equation. Now to find the another remainder two roots by using synthetic division, since the coefficients of this auxiliary equations are 1 minus 6 plus 12 minus 8. So by synthetic division to find the other roots, we proceed this division. Since the first root is equal to 2, now the process of synthetic division, 1 is it is 1 multiplied 2 is equal to 2. Now minus 6 plus 2 is equal to minus 4, and minus 4 multiplied 2 is equal to minus 8, and plus 12 minus 8 is equal to 4, and 2 for the 8, minus 8 plus 8 is equal to 0. So by this remainder equal to 0, 2 is the root of this characteristic equation. Now the another depressed equation is m square minus 4m plus 4 is equal to 0. So this is the depressed equation, m square minus 4m plus 4 is equal to 0. Now by using the formula a minus b whole square, a square minus 2ab plus b square is equal to 0, we obtain m minus 2 whole square is equal to 0. So m minus 2 whole square can be written as m minus 2 into m minus 2 is equal to 0. From this expressions we obtain m minus 2 is equal to m is equal to 2, and m minus 2 equal to 0 implies that m is equal to 2. So in this exact equation the roots are real and repeated, so we have three roots, 2 2 and 2, but the roots are repeated. So the complementary solution for this differential equation is equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square into e power mx. Since the m root is equal to 2, so the complementary solution is equal to c1 plus c2x plus c3x square into e power 2x. Now another example, y4 dash minus 8y double dash plus 16y is equal to 0. Now this differential equation can be written as d power 4 minus 8d square plus 16 into y is equal to 0, and the auxiliary equation for this differential equation is m power 4 minus 8m square plus 16 is equal to 0. And this equation can be written as by using the formula a minus b whole square, we can write m square minus 4 whole square is equal to 0, and m square minus 4 whole square can be written as m square minus 4 into m square minus 4, which implies that m plus 2 into m minus 2 and m plus 2 into m minus 2. This is the formula of a square minus b square, which can be written as m plus 2 into m minus 2, and this is also the formula a square minus b square. Now we can write m plus 2 into m minus 2. So there are four roots, m1 is equal to m2 is equal to 2. So these two roots are real and repeated, and these two roots are also real and repeated. Now the complementary solution, since 2 and minus 2 are both double roots of auxiliary equation, hence the complementary solution of the given differential equation by using case number 2, yc solution is equal to c1 plus c2x into e power m1x plus c3 plus c4x into e power m2x. So we consider m1 is equal to 2 2, and m2 is equal to minus 2 minus 2. So the complementary function yc is equal to c1 plus c2x into e power 2x plus c3 plus c4x into e power minus 2x. Now third example, y triple dash minus 2y dash minus 4y dash plus 8y is equal to 0, and this is differential equation can be written as d cube minus 2d square minus 4d plus 8 into y is equal to 0, and the auxiliary equation for this differential equation m cube minus 2m square minus 4m plus 8 is equal to 0. So by factorization, taking m square common from these two terms, we can write m square into m minus 2, and taking common minus 4 from these two terms, minus 4 into m minus 2 is equal to 0, and we can write this equations m square minus 4 into m minus 2 is equal to 0. So again by using the formula a square minus b square, we can write m plus 2 into m minus 2 into m minus 2 is equal to 0. This vector is it is, and applying the formula a square minus b square for this vector, m square minus 4 can be written as m plus 4 into m minus 2. So we obtain three roots, m1 plus m2 is equal to 2, and m3 is equal to minus 2. These two roots are real and repeated, and this is the real but different. So the complementary solution, c1 plus c2x into e power m1x plus c3 e power m2x. Suppose this is m1, but m1 is repeated, so c1 plus c2x into e power 2x plus c3 e power minus 2x. Now, another example, d cube minus 3d square plus 4 into y is equal to 0. This is a differential equation of higher order. So the auxiliary equation for this differential equation is m cube minus 3m square plus 4 is equal to 0. So after factorizing this auxiliary equation by using the synthetic division, as I have already discussed in the previous slide, we obtain the roots minus 1, 2 and 2. So the first one root is real and different, and the other two roots are real and repeated. So we obtain the complementary solution c1 e power m1x plus into c2 plus c3x into e power m3x. And we can write the complementary solution c1 e power m1x plus c2 plus c3x into e power 2x. Now case number 3, when the roots of the auxiliary equation are complex and distinct, mean the roots are imaginary, the roots are complex and different. For example, m1 is equal to alpha plus iota beta and m2 is equal to alpha minus iota beta. Then the complementary function will be e power alpha x into c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x. For example, we have a second order differential equation y double dash plus y is equal to 0. This differential equation can be written as d square plus 1 into y is equal to 0. And the auxiliary equation for this differential equation is m square plus 1 is equal to 0, which can be written as m square is equal to minus 1. And this implies that the roots are m is equal to plus minus under root minus 1. So m is equal to plus minus iota, minus 1 under root is equal to iota. So in this case, the roots of this auxiliary equation are complex and different, which can be written as alpha plus minus iota beta, which is equal to 0 plus minus iota beta. The alpha value in this expression is 0 and the beta value in this expression is 1. So the complementary solution e power alpha x into c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x. So putting the value of alpha in beta, we obtain yc is equal to e power 0 into c1 cos 1x plus c2 sin 1x. And now we can write the complementary function c1 cos x plus c2 sin x. Now another example for the case number 3, when the roots are complex and different. Y4 time derivative plus y4y is equal to 0, and this differential equation can be written as d power 4 plus 4 into y is equal to 0. And the auxiliary equation for this differential equation m power 4 plus 4 is equal to 0. So for the factorization, adding 4m square on both sides, we obtain m power 4 plus 4 plus 4m square minus 4m square is equal to 0. And simply we can say that add and subtract 4m square in the left hand side, m power 4 plus 4 plus 4m square minus 4m square is equal to 0. And we obtain a plus b whole square formula from these three terms, m power 4 plus 4 plus 4m square, m square plus 2 whole square minus 2m whole square. And now this is the formula a square minus b square, which can be written as a plus b into a minus b. So m square plus 2 m plus 2 into m square minus 2m minus 2 is equal to 0. Now suppose m square plus 2m plus 2 is equal to 0, then the roots of this equation, this is a quadratic equation, so to find the roots of this quadratic equation by using the quadratic formula, m is equal to minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac under root divided by 2a. So in this quadratic equation, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2 and c is equal to 2. So putting these values in the quadratic formula, we obtain the roots alpha 2 plus minus iota beta 2, which is equal to 1 plus minus iota beta. And if we consider this equation and to solve this quadratic formula, this quadratic equation by using the quadratic formula, then we obtain other roots, other complex roots. Suppose in the first quadratic equation, in the first quadratic equation, the roots plus 1 plus minus iota 1, and in the second quadratic equation, the roots is minus 1 plus minus iota 1. So we can write the complementary solution e power alpha x into c1 cos beta cos b1x plus c2 sin b1x plus e power alpha 2x into c1 cos beta 2x plus c2 sin beta 2x. So yc solution e power alpha value is 1. So the complementary solution for this differential equation is equal to e power 1x into c1 cos beta value is 1 plus c2 sin beta x, beta values here in this equation is 1, plus e power alpha, the alpha value is minus 1, c3 cos beta, beta value is 1, plus c4 sin beta x, beta value is 1. So in this quadratic equation the roots are 1 plus minus iota 1, and in this second equation the roots are minus 1 plus minus iota 1. So in this case there are two complex roots but different. So the complementary solution is equal to e power x into c1 cos x plus c2 sin x plus e power minus x into c3 cos x plus c4 sin x. And this is the end of this segment. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.